broken pillar is called the Nail. It was broken by something, and now the astral plane is bleeding into the foundation, which will destroy the oldest house, the bureau, and everyone inside. I need to find four locks, or keys, or whatever, to stop that from happening. But I'm the director. I've handled worse. This should be simple-ish. You with me? Is this a Bureau ID badge? Looks so old. Hope will definitely want to see this. weird place to leave an ID card, but okay. Another ID card. For a cartographer.
Spent inside what we're calling the oldest house. Northmore insists on the name. I'm too tired to ask why. I'm not sleeping well. Per orders, me and my research team have established a permanent examination lab in the Foundation. I basically live down here now, like the obedient head of research Father raised me to be. I spend my days investigating that odd pillar where Northmore found the handgun. The work was half-hearted at first, I admit. But then I discovered numerous non-Aristotelian energy channels converging at its base. Ley lines, dragon roads, Hylogalinian, call them what you want. But this pillar is the crossroads. I started building something. Equal parts talisman and technology. An array that can impose order on the ley junctions. That's the idea, at least. We'll see when I'm done. I prefer to work away from the pillar. I'm not the only one who feels like that thing has eyes. The oldest house. Orders. Me and my research. research team have established a permanent examination lab in the Foundation. I basically live down here now, like the obedient head of research father raised me to be. That odd pillar when Northmore found the hand. What was half-hearted at first, I admit. But then I discovered numerous non-Aristotelian energy channels converging at its base. Ley lines, dragon roads, Pelagalinium, Colmontumon. Entry day plus 51. Northmore has ordered an all-hands search for objects similar to the service weapon. He claims there are more in the house. Entry day plus 51. Northmore has ordered an all-hands search for objects similar to the service weapon. He claims there are more in the house. Though I don't see how he's so certain. He's been strange lately, talking about joining greater causes and frequently mentioning a pyramid. After pressing him, he finally described this pyramid to me. Inverted, black, mathematically perfect. Oddly enough, Adam and the other id have shown me numerous inverted triangles painted on the cave walls. Surely there's a connection, but I don't see it yet. As far as occult symbols go, triangles are by no means rare. Flood, Levi, Kroll, they used that shape like it was going out of fashion. Standing on their base, triangles signify stability and strength. Inverted on their points, they represent conflict and stagnation. Of course, the orientation is just a matter of perspective. Looking at the pyramid from below gives you one, from above, another. Northmore says he looks up at the inverted pyramid. I have to wonder, is anyone standing over it, looking down? I don't see how he's so certain. Thank you.
I'm here, aren't I? I saved the Bureau once, and I'll do it again.
I've served under two directors. Three now, I suppose. Trench and I worked our way up together. We made it through the tough cases, the bad days, the casualties. He was the epitome of a good agent. Smart, decisive, selfless. Then he picked up that damn gun. Becoming director is a formal process overseen by the board. Lots of ritual and mystery. After that, key staff provide detailed briefs on all classified matters, past and present. But with Faden, well, there's no protocol for field promotion. The girl's smart, has a good head on her shoulders. I'm trusting her to handle the hiss upstairs, while I hold them off here. All this shit with the nail, the board, I'm not sure she's ready. Besides, I work better alone.
Thank you. Thank you.
another etching, like the one I used to get in here. Key the board told me about? Just doing my job. Got this covered.
Jesse, hey!
What are you doing down here, Emily?
What do you mean? You called me down, remember?
I'm pretty sure I didn't.
No, that's right. You didn't. But then, I remember you needing me to come here. I mean, you even told me how to get in. Let's just chalk it up to synchronicity so we can get to work.
She takes everything in stride. The board called me down here to deal with the situation. The astral plane is
colliding with our world. I know, isn't it fascinating? I never even considered that the astral plane could be a physical volume expanding beyond its dimensional container. The bleed is localized to this area, but its growth rate seems steady. Given time, it will consume the entire Bureau, and possibly beyond.
That's what I'm here to stop. The board told me to fix the nail over there by dismantling 4 locks in the astral plane. Funny, I think it's put itself back together a bit.
So that could be due to the law of inverse exchange. For every associated component you remove, this nail reconstructs. Or possibly some variation of anti-sympathy. Don't worry. I'll look into it. Did you notice all the Bureau infrastructure? It looks like there was a research team stationed down here at some point. Do you think Darling knew about this?
I put money on it. That reminds me. Have you seen Marshall? She contacted me over the hotline, but then I saw her walking around.
I haven't seen her. The hotline only connects to extraplanar entities. Or dead people. But Marshall's proved time and time again that she's a survivor.
That's exactly what I thought.
Anyway, I've been looking into the minerals growing down here. Have you noticed how they insist on maintaining a certain form? Maybe some sort of a state memory, or they consciously prefer a certain shape? Or...
I think we're on a clock here, Emily. I need to stop the astral bleeding before it brings the oldest house down. See what you can find out from the Nail in the meantime. And send out some rangers to look for Marshall. She may be in trouble.
Will do, Jesse. If you see anything interesting, remember to take detailed notes. All the tests I run on the Nail keep coming back as nonsense, and a couple of my instruments have already broken.
Maybe we should take that as a sign to pack it in?
I didn't take you for a quitter, Dr. Saba. There's a reason I packed a black rock-plated microscope.
This area looks newer. Is it from the upper floors?
Send a ranger to my location.
Reinforcements are here!
Thank you.
Someone call a plumber.
Item detected in Transport Bay. Access is prohibited for safety regulation 18A.
No power. Typical. They should hire someone who builds smaller machines. Thank you.
worst I've ever seen. Is take the nail. End of the world.
So I can't let the hiss take the nail. Not a problem. I know how to handle them.
I snuck into the Foundation through a back door I know. Had to get ahead of the hiss. Just a matter of bypassing the ritual protections. Luckily, the board's as distracted as the rest of the Bureau. I had to put on a brave face up there, but the situation is the worst I've ever seen. We're getting back on our feet, but we've already lost so much. Trench is dead. Darling is somewhere. I'm the only one left. But I still have a job to do. Keep the hiss back. There's not enough HRAs to spare, so I'll have to make do with what I've got. Frankly, I don't even know what will happen if the hiss take the nail. Trench made it sound like it'd be the end of the world. He was never one to exaggerate. Well, orders are orders, even if they come from a dead man.
Another etching.
Okay, what the hell is going on? Wait, I'm back here? Wasn't my idea. Blame the eyeball. But it is giving you something you won't. I don't like you deciding what I can't slash.
Thank you.
I'm getting pretty tired of being jerked around the astral plane. If you're listening, I want some answers! Hi there. It was nice of you to give me something the board wouldn't. What are you getting out of it? So, I'm just supposed to believe you're a particularly charitable... whatever you are? Hungry? I mean, yeah, actually, I'd love a sandwich or something. That's not what you meant, was it? Are you part of the board? Or used to be? Okay, so you split because the board blamed you for... Gotta be easier to play charades. Do I need to rescue someone? I don't know what I expected. Listen, this has been great, but I have to go. Thanks for your help, and stay out of trouble. Should I trust either of them? Isn't my favorite director. Jesse, you're back! So did you find anything noteworthy? The original Bureau expedition down here left so much interesting stuff behind. Like their ID cards. I picked up a weird one. It's pretty old. Oh wow, look at that. Yeah, I found a few ID cards myself. Or, more accurately, the Rangers found them for me. Are you starting a collection? I'm going for the whole set. I kid, of course. But I suppose they are sort of like baseball cards, except for Bureau stuff from the 60s. Hey, the one you found is different than mine. It looks like it's a higher clearance level. A rare one, then. Want to keep it, Emily? Yeah, I absolutely do. But I think you should hang on to it for now. High clearance access might come in handy.
Sounds like you have something in mind.
Guilty. See, I've been going through Dr. Ash's notes, or
The ones I can find, anyway. Like Darling, he seemed to enjoy hiding his most relevant research. From what I gather, there is another floor beneath the warehouse with a special lab that requires 5 high-level staff members just to access. Here, take this. It's an old skeleton key. Something else the Rangers found. I give them $5 for every useful trinket they bring me.
I'm gonna assume this key is my ticket to that lower floor. And that super secret lab you mentioned.
Bingo bango, as Dr. Darling used to say. But keep your eyes peeled for more ID cards around the warehouse. If Ash's notes are reliable, and I'm sure they are, then 5 is the magic number. The Rangers found a section of the containment sector in the caves, but no house shifts occur down here. Strange.
How did the Hiss get into the Foundation?
Same way we did, I imagine. But you need to remember that the Hiss are the embodiment of persistence. Their nature seems to be one of force, to find every possible vulnerability and exploit it. Their only goal is consumption.
I'm sure there's plenty of goodies for them down here. The Nail, for instance.
If the Hiss could corrupt the Nail, I'm sure they would have by now. It must not interest them in its broken state. They could be distracted by the numerous unknown paranatural materials I'm sure are lying around. These are the roots of the oldest house. The Hiss will find plenty of ways to make trouble.
They're pretty good at that. So you've never heard of the Foundation, huh?
I've never even seen the name referenced. Clearly it's highly classified, but for what reason? The problem with these kinds of closed-off hidden areas is that they were likely sealed for good reason. But now no one is left to tell us what that reason was.
Any guesses why the Bureau would hide something like this?
I only know what I've observed. This place is spatially rigid, which means it doesn't shift like the rest of the oldest house. And before you ask why that is, I have to admit that I'm clueless. There's some signal interfering with my equipment, making it hard to get a clear reading. It's being emitted from the floor. Maybe I should have brought a jackhammer.
The astral plane is already taking chunks out of this place, Emily. Let's not add to it. So let me get this straight. The astral plane is bleeding into the Foundation.
Correct.
And that's happening because the Nail is damaged.
I'd say it's a bit more than damaged, but yes, that is my understanding.
So what's the connection between the Nail and the astral plane?
It's a good question. See, I always pictured objects of power as strings between our plane and the astral. If the Nail has a similar relationship, then maybe it's more accurate to think of it like plumbing. Now that the Nail is busted, sewage is gushing everywhere.
Not the prettiest metaphor.
I should get back out there.
Agreed. The astral bleed won't stop itself.
Don't be a stranger.
Thank you.
My life's happiness. Strange one. Certainly stranger than I'd like. But this place, it's something else. The floors crawl, the walls slither, it's a shifting pit. On the street, it's just another drab building standing there for anyone to see. No one does. How do we miss it? Northmore. Acting director Northmore now is on a train from Washington. He'll expect answers, which is why I'm making these tapes. They're evidence that I'm at least trying to understand. Father searched his entire life for something like this, and we find it 1 week after he's buried. He always hated irony. Of course, Father, the great director Ash, would have been the first man.
Be listening to weird entity A or B or neither. Let's just stay the course for now. The Bureau's in danger. We know we need to repair the nail. The astral plane won't break reality on my watch.
Thank you.
41 days since entry day. The name of our historic arrival filled with health. Morale is long dead, and its corpse is starting to smell. My research staff complain of a presence watching them. Many have suffered nervous fits. Some were evacuated. In cheerier news, I've made some new friends. I met them while exploring the deeper caves. They're hard to describe, but imagine avant-garde sculptures of humans. I call them the Id. They aren't hostile. In fact, they're polite and quiet, which is more than I can say for my colleagues. Most Id are shy, but a few were quite curious. While I sat taking notes, one came to look at my sketches. I offered him my pencil, but that spooked it. What are the Id? Residents? Prisoners? They remind me of the golems from Kabbalistic texts, or a type of homunculi. I know I shouldn't, but I gave them names. There's Hercules, Adam, Lilith, Copernicus. Mabel is the bravest. They're a funny bunch.
Send a ranger to my location.
Let's put him down! Get around them!
Thank you.
There's the etching. They sure changed their tune all of a sudden. I'm overthinking this whole board former thing. They can sort out their own business so long as it doesn't get in my way. Obsessing over these problems is something Trench would do, but I've got my intuition. And you.
Hey, try not to launch me, Director. Nah, I'm just kidding.
If it isn't my favorite director. The nail is almost repaired. You really do have a knack for this kind of work. Any progress with the nail?
Of course. I've been busy with surface analysis. Its composition is remarkably similar to that of material found in the astral plane, but it alters itself between my observations. It's almost as if it doesn't like being examined.
So the nail is from the astral plane?
Not necessarily. See, if we assume that, we're suddenly facing a lot of new questions. How did something so large get out of the astral plane? How did it get inside the oldest house? Did a threshold bring it in? Did people? Maybe through the motel.
Maybe it was always here.
Doubtful.
Have you spent any time looking into the crystals growing around here?
As if I could resist. The biggest question is where it comes from. A threshold? Or is it native to the Foundation? But if so, why doesn't it grow in the rest of the oldest house? The fact that they returned to an earlier state when damaged is severely inconsistent with our reality's adherence to linear time. So either they're A, partially conscious, or B, organic elements that are foreign to and yet influenced by our dimension. The jury's still out. Have you learned anything about the crystals?
I have a power that lets me stretch them.
Huh.
Yep. Any idea what Marshall would be doing down here?
That information is on a need-to-know basis, Faden. Sorry, I can resist. But honestly, I never had much interaction with Marshall. She only came to me when she was looking for Darling. But this is Helen Marshall we're talking about, the woman who single-handedly dealt with the Bergen Peak AWE. If she's down here, it's because she needs to be.
Well, clearly she couldn't handle this one on her own.
I'll see you later, Emily. Good luck. Take notes.
What was she thinking?
The hiss got in. The Foundation is overrun. I was out of time and out of options. I took all the C4 I could get my hands on and strapped it to the nail. Boom. A desperate move. But it's better off in pieces than in enemy hands. Trench wouldn't be thrilled. He always said how vital the nail was. How it was the Bureau's duty to protect it. Bullshit. Those years spent in the Director's chair warped his priorities. In the end, he valued order over people. The advice of invisible voices over that of old friends. He lost sight of who he was. The board made sure of that. But I did my duty. The hiss can't corrupt a pile of smoking rubble. My last act as head of operations. I'm done. At least I could take those bastards down with me.
Worse. the cave sand. Looks like the astral bleed goes both ways. In the astral plane. Thank you.
The Bureau does not have windows. Reminder, the Bureau does not have windows. If you notice a window, immediately close your eyes and make your way to the nearest safe room. You are permitted to fashion a blindfold from an article of clothing. Any resulting lapse in dress code will be excused. Thank you for your attention. If you notice a window, immediately close your eyes and make your way to the nearest safe room. You are permitted to fashion a blindfold from an article of clothing. Any resulting lapse in dress code will be excused. Thank you for your attention.
Yeah.
entry day plus 86. There's been a change. Hercules and Mabel, I mean, id numbers 3 and 11 attacked my staff today. 2 fatalities. 3 if you count Mabel. She was always so kind. As a result, we are abandoning the Foundation. Northmore gave the order to transfer our resources to the upper floors. Now that my control points allow us to safely come and go from the New York streets, did I forget to include that fact in my previous logs? I've been so busy. Using the arrays I made, control points have been established throughout the oldest house. Excuse me if I don't sound excited, it's just... A few months ago, I would have been overjoyed to leave the Foundation. But now I realize I've grown fond of it. There's something deep in the stone here, deeper than that watching presence. Something warm. I feel it needing me. I won't go. I'll refuse. Northmore won't be happy, but so be it. I'm starting to see him for what he is. An impotent storm. Father Shade in a cheap suit.
Thank you.
believe Marshall's brilliant plan was to blow up the nail. And she thought I wasn't ready. There. Easy as pie.
Fuck! But that's the last one! I fixed it, didn't I?
Better now, not worse.